So if you are just getting started with video production or filmmaking, you might have suddenly realized that frame rates are a lot more complicated than you thought. So that means you're probably wondering what is the right frame rate to use for your video production. Do you need to use 24 frames a second? Do you want to use 60 frames a second, or even something much more extreme like 120 frames a second or 240 frames a second? So when I first started in video production, I, like pretty much everyone else when they first starts, wants that super cinematic, silky slow-mo look. And that means it can be super tempting to just shoot everything in 60 frames a second. That means you can just pick and choose what you want slowed down and what you want to look real-time, more like normal motion. And this is wrong for a few reasons, and we're going to talk about those in this video. But I'm still sort of guilty of this to a certain extent. So I wanted to really test myself. I wanted to go out, shoot a sort of cinematic sequence. In the end, I shot almost like a concept spec ad for a brand here in the UK, but I wanted to do that using only 24 frames a second, or at least the majority of the video shot in 24 frames a second. So let's roll that clip, and then we'll talk about the videos and the frame rates used in the production shortly. I'm refusing the yard, feeling like a champion. I can't sleep, no ambient. Feeling every beat I'm landing on. So infinity ambient. This ain't like I work for this. I'm gonna show y'all what urgent is. Never been way more certain than. Ain't nobody more deserving, man. Make way for what's up, creators? My name is Tom. Welcome back to the channel. Come for the cameras, stay for the accent. I hope you enjoyed that small sequence. If you go on to learn something in this video, all I ask is you maybe hit the thumbs up button down below. First of all, before we go any further in this video, I am in Europe. This means I use what is called the PAL standard of video, whereas the USA uses something called NTSC. This is all super complicated, sounds really complex, but that just basically means that I actually shoot in 25 frames a second and 50 frames a second. But for the majority of this video, I'm going to be talking about 24 frames a second and 60 frames a second, because that is more common around the world. The same principles apply, definitely, they just are those different numbers. Okay, so let's talk about 24 frames a second and 60 frames a second, and when you might want to use each of those different frame rates. So the simple breakdown is that 24 frames a second is almost like film standard for real-time footage. It will also give you the most realistic motion blur in your footage. So if I go like this, you can see that the blur on my hand is looking quite natural. So at 24 frames a second, your motion and your movement will look real. This generally means that for projects like documentary stuff, talking heads, interviews, anything where there's a camera filming something and you need it to look, close to real time and nice and realistic, you'll want to shoot that in 24 frames a second. This video right here is being shot in 25 frames a second, and I want the motion to look nice and realistic. Whereas the advantage of shooting 60 frames a second is you have an option to slow your footage down in post when you're working in a 24 frames a second timeline. You can actually slow that footage by 40% and you get a really nice, super smooth, slow motion effect. Now this isn't super slow motion like 120 frames a second or 240 frames a second. Those frame rates are reserved for basically accenting something that's happening in the picture. So maybe you're filming a skateboarding project and you want to particularly focus on one trick, you would probably do that in 120 or 240 frames a second, because you're really going to be able to slow that motion down and bring focus onto that movement. With 60 frames a second, what is more common is that you're wanting to either make something a little bit more cinematic, or perhaps you're filming human movements and you want those to be slightly slower than real life. Things will just look a little bit more ethereal and dreamy. So talking about the sequence that we just saw, the sequence that I shot, I used a whole bunch of 24 frames a second, and I only used 60 frames a second a couple of times in that entire project, and that was for a few different reasons. First of all is that in 24 frames a second, you're gonna get a more realistic, much nicer camera shake. Because the motion is totally real time, or close to real time, it means that those shakes are actually, you know, fully real time. They're actually happening in the shot. Whereas if I slowed all of that footage down to 60 frames a second, that camera shake is actually going to look less dramatic, meaning that the handheld effect and the run and gun style that I wanted for that video isn't gonna be as impactful. Next would be the motion blur. I used quite a lot of these sort of either whip transitions, or actually using the camera's sort of transitions frames of movement to help the flow of the video. If I'd have shot this all in 60 frames a second, I wouldn't have been getting as realistic or nice motion blur in a lot of these clips. And finally, because I wanted the pace and the speed of the edit, I definitely wanted to shoot this in 24 frames a second because I want that sort of run and gun, high paced feel. And by shooting that at 24, that's the easiest way to achieve that look. If I shot this all in 60 and even slowed that down, it definitely would have made the video feel much more choppy and not as realistic. I did use a couple of 60 frames a second shots in the video. It wasn't exclusively 24 frames a second. First of all was the shot of me tracking Josh. So I was actually following him with the camera from behind and he was running off in front of me. And then the second one was Josh actually landing a jump. And obviously I wanted to accent that jump because it was one of the more impressive moves in the video. And there's one other candidate that I actually could have shot in 60 frames a second. In the end, I went with 24, but that's the backflip. I could have really used that slow motion to accent that trick, but the rest of the whole video would have been at 24. So now let's revisit what we talked about at the start of the video. And this is why you don't just want to shoot everything at 60 frames a second and then just choose the bits that you want to slow down, because this definitely is tempting. You'd think you'd be basically getting the best of both worlds by being able to pick and choose the bits that you do want slow motion and then having the rest run normal real time. And the most important reason why we don't do this generally is the motion is not going to look realistic in your videos. So those 60 frames a second clips, you're speeding up essentially in a 24 frames a second timeline, you've just got way too much data going through that video. Everything's gonna look choppy and very fast. You can see here from this clip of Josh running, if I play that 60 frames a second clip back at 24 frames a second, this doesn't look like normal running. This doesn't look like it would have done if I'd shot it at 24 frames a second. Whereas if I slow that down to 60 frames a second, it's actually going to look much more realistic and much more cinematic. Definitely the correct approach for shooting 24 or 60 frames a second is to choose when and where you might want to do it. So, you know, I knew that I was wanting to film that jump in 60 frames a second and the running shot in 60 frames a second, and then everything else was going to be shot in 24 because I wanted it to be nice and quick. Another approach which is very commonly used in filmmaking and particularly things like documentaries is your A-roll, your sort of shot like this, maybe it's an interview shot, is being shot in 24 at real time, and then all of the B-roll, all of the overlay footage is all shot in 60 frames a second because that does give the flexibility to slow everything down. But the same is true when we talk about planning it out, because on the whole, all of that footage will be played in slow motion because it is sort of all being used to accent what the person is talking about in the main A-roll shot. And guys, that's kind of it for this one. Like, I just wanted to briefly discuss the frame rates, show you guys that project that I worked on over the last couple of days. I'm gonna start trying to incorporate actually shooting something like that and talking about it here on the channel. Hopefully you do find it interesting. Let me know what you think down below in the comments. If you have any questions about frame rates, definitely leave them down below as well. And also maybe a suggestion for the intro in the next video. And I will catch you guys next time.